Hello students, in last video we saw the heredity and revolution part 1. In that we learn the heredity and hybrid varieties of crops and animals. In this lecture, this is the heredity and evolution part 2 lecture. In this video we are going to start with transcription, translocation, translation. Now we will say what is this all. You will come to know slowly. This is the steps involved in protein synthesis. So basically we are going to learn protein synthesis, and we'll start students here. We'll start with transcription, translation and translocation. Here, information about protein synthesis is stored in the DNA. Information about protein synthesis is stored in the DNA. Students, we know what is DNA. In the last lecture, I have already shown you what is DNA is, students. When you will see, this is just for revision. We know the human body is made up of many cells. All cells are having nucleus. Nucleus are having chromosomes. And each chromosome is having, it is made up of a DNA. Each chromosome is made up of a single DNA, students. Now here, in single DNA, each segment of DNA is called genes, students. Each segment of DNA is called genes. So students, you know what is chromosome, what is DNA. DNA is a basic unit, building block of chromosome, basic building block of chromosomes. Here chromosomes are having segments, and each segment of chromosome is called gene, students. So you will remember this information, and on the basis of this information we'll move ahead, students. When we have studied the structure of DNA in last lecture, students, so here we are having DNA. DNA is the one which is there in chromosome, and chromosomes come from parents. We know, students, that at the time of reproduction, first male and female, they give their one chromosome, one chromosome of male and one chromosome of female, take part in reproduction. And the DNA structure is a basic unit present in chromosome. So DNA comes from male, DNA comes from female via chromosome of male, chromosome of female. And this DNA, when comes, DNA carries the information. I will show you, students, later when we'll move in a lecture, you will come to know how the informations are carried by DNA. Here proteins are synthesized by DNA through the RNA. This is called central dogma. This process of synthesis of protein from DNA through RNA is called central dogma, students. So please remember this central dogma. What is central dogma? I'll repeat again. Proteins are synthesized by DNA through RNA. This is called central dogma, students. Now let's ahead, students. Now when we are talking about DNA, before we'll move ahead in this chapter, I'll just give a short information about RNA. In last definition you saw that DNA synthesizes protein through RNA. Now what is RNA? RNA is of three types, friends. RNA is of three types. One is mRNA, second is rRNA, and third is tRNA. I'll explain you both mRNA, RNA and tRNA. All three I'll explain you. But at present you just remember the short information about mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. And this is information is like mRNA. M here in mRNA, M stands for messenger. इट कैरीज द जेनेटिक कोड फ्रॉम DNA टू साइटोप्लाज्म एंड राइबोसोम्स. व्हाट इज दिस? आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू इन डिटेल लेटर व्हेन वी विल मूव अहेड इन लेक्चर स्टूडेंट. सो एट प्रेजेंट यू जस्ट रिमेंबर M फॉर मैसेंजर RNA, T फॉर ट्रांसफर RNA एंड R फॉर राइबोसोमल RNA. सो mRNA, tRNA एंड rRNA. tRNA ट्रांसफर RNA स्मॉल मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट ट्रांसफर अमाइनो एसिड टू राइबोसोम. सो इट्स वर्क इज टू ट्रांसफर द अमाइनो एसिड टू द राइबोसोम. नाउ राइबोसोमल फॉर्म्स द पार्ट ऑफ राइबोसोम सो वी लर्न दिस ऑल इन डिटेल. एट प्रेजेंट यू विल जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट RNA इज R ऑफ 3 टाइप, mRNA, rRNA एंड tRNA. RNA R ऑफ 3 टाइप्स, mRNA, RNA एंड tRNA. M फॉर मैसेंजर, T फॉर ट्रांसफर एंड R फॉर राइबोसोमल. सो यू विल रिमेंबर. लेट्स मूव अहेड. नाउ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ mRNA. हाउ mRNA इज फॉर्म स्टूडेंट्स? नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ mRNA इज फॉर्म. mRNA इज प्रोड्यूस्ड एज पर द सिक्वेंस ऑफ न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स ऑफ DNA. Now, what is nucleotide? Students, we have already studied DNA, structure of DNA. When you will see the structure of DNA, I'll show you structure of DNA. Here, this DNA we have already studied in our last lecture, students. This is a DNA. In this DNA, the horizontal lines are there, which is made up of nitrogenous bases. These horizontal lines are called nucleotides. These are called nucleotides. mRNA is produced as per the sequence of nucleotides on DNA. Only one of the two strands of DNA is used in this process. Students, here when you will see, there are two strands. One strand is there and this is the second strand. Two strands are there in this DNA. In this DNA, two strands are there. Out of these two strands, only one strand is going to be used. Now here, RNA structure is also shown here, students. RNA is shown here. So we are having both DNA and RNA shown here. When you will see this RNA, students, see G, C, one strand. C is there, students. G is there. A is there. Now here only one change you will able to see, that instead of T, U is there. So whenever DNA, RNA is formed, everything is same. Only one strand is used and everything is same. What is the difference? Instead of thymine, there is uracil, students. There is uracils. So total 4 are there. Cytosine is same, guanine is same, adenine is same, but instead of 4th nitrogenous bases, thymine, there is uracil in RNA. So this is the difference. Please remember, students. Please remember this. We are having DNA, we are having RNA. DNA is having horizontal lines called as nucleotides. Each nucleotide is made up of 2 nitrogenous bases. Now out of the two strands of DNA, here one strand is there, students. This is the one strand, and the second strand is there, students. Out of the two strands, only one strand is going to be used, students. Here we'll use only one strand, and there will be difference. Everything is going to be same. All the nucleotides are going to be same. G instead of G, here G is there. C, we are having C, G, we are having G, A, we are having A. Only instead of thymine, we'll have uracil, students. Instead of thymine, we'll have uracil. So this is how RNA is formed. The sequence of nucleotide in mRNA being produced is always complementary to DNA strand. used for synthesis. Beside, there is uracil. There is uracil in RNA instead of thymine. I explained you students, instead of uracil, there will be thymine, and so uracil is there instead of thymine in RNA students. This process of RNA synthesis is called transcription. So this is called transcription students. Formation of mRNA is called, from DNA, is nothing but called transcription students. So you have learned what is transcription is there. Let's move ahead students. Now I'll compare DNA and RNA students. Now we'll do comparative study between DNA and RNA. Here DNA full form, full name is deoxyribose sugar, and RNA is a ribose sugar students. DNA is a deoxyribose sugar and RNA is ribose sugar. Nitrogenous bases present in DNA is guanine, cytosine, adenine and thymine. Here also same, only one change is there. Instead of thymine, uracil is there. Guanine, cytosine and adenine. Instead of thymine, here we are having uracil strands. Now here we have already learned in the structure of DNA that thymine makes the pair with adenine and cytosine makes the pair with guanine. But here thymine is not there. Instead of thymine, uracil is there. So uracil will make pair with adenine and cytosine will make pair with guanine strands. So please remember this pair strands: guanine cytosine. In DNA, thymine adenine, here thymine is not there, uracil is there instead of thymine, so uracil adenine. So this is about the difference between DNA and RNA strands. Here one more thing, when you will see DNA and RNA, RNA is having uracil and DNA is having thymine. Instead of that, one more difference is there: DNA is having double strand, is double stranded, and RNA is having only single strand, it is single stranded. DNA can self replicate and form mRNA. RNA can be formed from DNA, but RNA can't form DNA. So RNA can't self replicate. RNA can't self replicate students. Now let's move ahead students. The mRNA formed in nucleus comes, see students, we have already seen that DNA, nucleus, see, cell, inside the cell, nucleus is there, inside the nucleus, chromosome is there, students. And chromosome is made up of DNA. So if chromosome is inside the nucleus, DNA is also there inside the nucleus only. So DNA is inside the nucleus. When this DNA will form mRNA will also be there in nucleus only. mRNA will also be there in nucleus only, students. Now here, this mRNA which is formed in nucleus, see here students, in this diagram you can see the DNA which is formed in nucleus, it comes out through a nuclear pore. Students, you can see it comes red color mRNA which is formed from blue color DNA, you can see DNA. From DNA, mRNA is formed. This is called transcription. And from transcription, after mRNA is formed, it comes out of the nucleus through this nuclear pore and it enters to cytoplasm. When mRNA comes out of the nucleus into cytoplasm, the code, that nucleotides, is only called codes. Those codes he will bring with itself to the cytoplasm. So the codes which is there in DNA is carried by mRNA to the cytoplasm. I'll repeat students, DNA is in nucleus. This DNA will form mRNA, mRNA which is formed will come out of the nucleus through a nuclear pore and it will enter to the cytoplasm. Now here students, we'll go ahead. It brings the coded message of DNA. It brings the coded message of DNA. Students, when you will see this structure here, these are the nucleotides. They are also called coded code message. This is nothing but a code message. Here we can see the arrangement is there, students. Arrangement is there. G, C, C, it may be G, G, G. So like that, students. Students, here, when you will see, these all are called coded message. This is nothing but a coded message which is carried by mRNA from DNA into the nucleus to the cytoplasm, students, to the cytoplasm here. So mRNA, which carries the coded message of DNA to the cytoplasm, when it enters into cytoplasm here, the message contains code for amino acids. These codes are for amino acids, students. Now you will say, what is amino acids? Amino acids are basic building block of protein, students. Like for our body is made up of cells, students. Our body is made up of cells. In the same way, our body is made up of cells. In the same way, proteins are having building block called amino acids, students. The code for each amino acid consists of three nucleotides. It is called triplet codons. I'll explain you what is triplet codon, students. When you will I'll just explain you one second here. When you will see this picture here, DNA is shown. It is straight. DNA is shown. From DNA, RNA is formed. See, students, you can see A. See, instead of T, what is the difference here? When you will see this row, is exactly same as this. Only difference is that T instead of T, U is there. Instead of T, U is there. Remaining everything, whatever you will see, you will say that it is same. C. G A A. Everything is same. Only difference is there. TT instead of TUU is there. T is for thymine. And U is for uracil. So here from DNA we got RNA. And RNA is having 3-3. Pair of 3-3 codes. Nucleotides. 3-3 codes. Nucleotides, and these are called as triplet codons. Students, these triplet codons, these thousands of triplet codons are there on a single strand of a RNA, students. So RNA carries the set of thousands of triplet codons, and each triplet codon is related to a type of amino acid. A type of amino acid we'll discuss again later. At present, you just remember that these set of 3-3 nucleotides are called codons, friends. Triplet codons. We'll move back to the same slide here, friends. Now here, the code for each amino acid consists of 3 nucleotides, and it is called triplet codon. So amino acids are there, and for each amino acid there is a different code, and these codes are consist of 3 nucleotides, and they are called as triplet codons. Let's move ahead. Before we'll go ahead in this chapter, I'm having a small introduction about a scientist, Dr. Hargovind Khurana. Dr. Hargovind Khurana, a scientist of Indian origin, has made an important contribution in discovery of triplet codon for 20 amino acids. Students, Dr. Hargovind Khurana, he has given a great contribution. He has discovered the triplet codons for 20 amino acids, friends. And for his work, he has been awarded with the Nobel Prize. Friends, Nobel Prize is not a joke, friends. It is given by the world authorities. and for there are few scientists who have got this Nobel Prize students. So the Dr. Hargobind Khurana has also awarded with the Nobel Prize in 1968 for his great work students. So please remember the name Hargobind Khurana. He has discovered triplet codons for 20 amino acid, and he has been awarded for the Nobel awarded with the Nobel Prize in 1968 for his great work students. So let's move ahead, students. Now we have done transcription. Our next topic is translation, students. Now when we'll talk about translation, students, each mRNA is made up of thousands of triplet codons. I have explained, students, I already explained, each triplet codon each mRNA is consists of thousands of triplet codons. See, you can see three triplet codons are there. Each mRNA is made up of thousands of triplet codons. As per the message on mRNA, amino acids are supplied by tRNA. Now, message is brought by mRNA in a ribosome. Now here, mRNA will carry this message. According to the mRNA message triplet codon, tRNA will supply the amino acid. How? I'll explain you here, students. You can see here, students, mRNA is there. mRNA is having triplet codons, students. So these triplet codons, here for each triplet codon, there is anticodon present at tRNA, students. For each triplet codon, there is anticodon. If codon and anticodon will match, then only they will able to join. So that is the reason why it is called as message, students. This is called message, students. Now here, when you will see, I already told you, students, adenine makes the pair with uracil in mRNA because thymine is not there, students. So uracil is there, and guanine makes the pair with cytosine, students. Adenine with uracil and guanine with cytosine, students. So you will just remember this, students. Adenine makes pair with the uracil and guanine makes the pair with cytosine. I'll write here over at the corner. Adenine makes the pair with uracil and guanine makes the pair with cytosine. Now here, when you will see A is there. So opposite to A, what should be there? U should be there. Yeah, U is there. So it is anti. A against A, what should be there? Anticodon here. This is called codon. The triplet nucleotides present on mRNA is called codon, students, and the triplet of nucleotides present on tRNA is called anticodons. When codon and anticodon will make pair, then only they will able to join. Students, here AA is there, so against A U should be there. Here UU is there, yeah, so it will join. This tRNA will able to join. Now this tRNA is having a type of amino acid present over here. So this amino acid will be transferred or produced by this tRNA for this triplet codon. So for different codons, there are different anticodons. I'll just rub this highlighter so it will be a little clear. Now here, students, suppose instead of this AAA, suppose I am taking these three. Suppose A, G, C is there. So this is a codon present at mRNA. So at tRNA, what should be there? RNA. So here at tRNA, what should be there? Against A, what should be there? U should be there. So U against G, G, C should be there. And against C, C makes pair with G. So G should be there. If U, C, G is there, U, C, G is there, then this is the perfect anticodon for this codon. For this codon, we will have perfect anticodon U, C, G. And if it matches, then only tRNA will able to join with this codon. And when it will join, it will produce a amino acid. It will produce a amino acid of different type according to the anticodon message. So this is about codon and anticodon, students. Let's continue. Here, for this purpose, tRNA has anticodon. So you understood what is anticodon is there. Now, having complementary sequence. So you saw that for codon, there is anticodon, which is complementary to the codon on mRNA, This is called translation, students. Here, let's move ahead, students. Now, we'll move to next point here. The amino acid brought by tRNA. Now, when tRNA will join with the codon, tRNA is having anticodon. See, students, you can see tRNA is having anticodon and mRNA is having codon. When these two codon and anticodon, they will match, they are complementary, they will join and this tRNA will produce amino acid. This tRNA are bonded together by the peptide bonds with the help of tRNA. I'll explain you with the help of rRNA. Now I'll tell you what is rRNA here. Then you will see, two tRNA are there, which are just having the complementary sequence of these codons, which are having anticodons complementary to codons, so they can join. Now they will attach to the anticodons. Codons and anticodons, they will get attached at the same time with the help of ribosomal RNA. These are ribosomes. You can see here blue color and yellow color ribosomes are shown here, students. I'll just rub this highlighter and I'll show you ribosomes. Ribosomes are shown here, blue color and yellow color, because with the help of this ribosomal RNA, with the help of this ribosomes, these amino acids get attached. With the help of peptide bonds. Once these two amino acids are produced and attached, this ribosomal, this second tRNA will attach to the second, anticodon of second tRNA will attach to the codon of the mRNA, and this ribosome, you can see, it will move one step ahead and it will help the amino acid produced by the next tRNA to attach with the previous one with the help of peptide bonds. And in this way, the amino acids will be produced and getting attached to each other, and this process will continuously done, and the formation of protein take place. During this process, the ribosomes keep moving from one in sorry one sorry it should be end here it is the it may be a typing mistake here, students. Please consider it. Of mRNA to other end of the distance of the one triplet codon, this is called translocation, students. I'll stop today's lecture here only. Today we learn the translation and translocation. This is nothing but protein synthesis. Here we saw the amino acids are produced and they are getting attached, and this is nothing but protein formation. So we learn protein synthesis with the help of DNA and RNA. In next lecture, In next lecture, we'll talk about mutation and other topics, and we'll move ahead, students. For today, students, I'll stop my lecture here, and I'll say thank you to you all for today's lecture. Don't forget to watch my next video. In next video, we'll continue the heredity and evolution part 3, and I'll try to finish the chapter heredity and evolution in coming part 3 and part 4. So this chapter you will able to finish in coming 2 videos. And for today, thank you, students. Don't forget to watch the next video.